Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard. Today our chapter is going to be the transformation of sentences. We know that this one is a very important topic for ICSE as well as ISE. It is important for class 9 and class 10 and even class 12s and 11s and 12s, for them also it is very important. So I think my video will help you a lot to understand these few grammar and do as directed is given to you. You have to do it in question number 4. Over there, at least one or two questions you will get on these types. So it is very important that you study these carefully. It is very easy and I will make it very helpful and easy for you all so that you can understand it well. What are the types that we are going to discuss here today? Type 1 is going to be no sooner. I think all of you are familiar with this, no sooner and then. This one is one type, and the other type which we are going to discuss is type 2, hardly. Okay, the sentences that start with no sooner and the sentences that start with hardly. These are the two kinds that we are going to do today. Why are we doing this together? We are doing this together because this topic is similar. These both of the topics are similar to one another. So it will become very helpful. So best of luck. Let's start with this. If you like the video, please subscribe and let your friends see my video too. Okay, type 1. What is type 1? Type 1, you already know, we are discussing no sooner. Okay, see, there are two forms over here which we need to discuss. First one is the present form. Present form means when we see that the sentence is written in the present tense. See the first example. As soon as my friend gets up. What tense is this? This is present tense because it is written gets. Gets means it is in the present tense. And even this is the present form of the tense, reads. So what is the sentence? As soon as my friend gets up, he reads the newspaper. What does this sentence mean? The sentence means that as soon as, immediately, when my friend gets up, what does he do? He reads the newspaper. Now this is what? This is a habitual fact. Always my friends do this. Okay. So no sooner. How will I write the same sentence when we started with no sooner? We have to remember that we need to use a helping verb. What are the helping verbs? Helping verbs are do, does, did, has, have, isn't it? Had. These are all the helping verbs. Now, when do we use does? When do we use do? Why are we not writing here do? Because the noun over here for which we are using this verb is in the singular form. If it was friends, if it was written my friends, then when it is plural, we would write here do. When it is singular, we write here does. So no sooner does my friend get up. We know that when we use a helping verb, our tense changes in the helping verb, not in the verb. So verb will be in the first form. First form of get is get. Third form, first form, second form and third form. There are three forms of the verb. So when we are writing the helping verb in the present tense, our verb form will be the first form. So no sooner does my friend get up, you must remember that we need to use the word than over here. First part of the sentence is done. No sooner does my friend get up, then you use the word than. Then again, the sentence is in present form. So you write the present form here also. He reads the newspaper. So first part will have no sooner does my friend get up. Okay, then you add the word than and then the next part of the sentence. What does he do? He reads the newspaper. We have to remember if the sentence is in the present form, then we need to use the helping verb. What helping verbs? Either does or do. When we will use does? When it is singular. When it is plural, you will write do. If it was my friends, then it would be no sooner do my friends get up than they read the newspaper. Clear? Next, we'll move to the past form. This is one form, very easy. Past form. This is the other form. There are only two forms. Present form we have done. This is the past form. See example 2. As soon as I opened the door. So one action is what? I opened the door. What is the second thing? I found my dog standing outside. Two parts. I opened the door And what did I see? I found my dog was standing outside. So what tense is this? This is the past tense. Now how will you change the same sentence starting with no sooner when this is written in the past? The first one was in the present form. This one is in the past form. How will you change this? So in the past form, the helping verb is going to be did. Okay, you need to use the helping verb did. So no sooner did I open the door than, again see, in all no sooner sentences, after the first part of the sentence is done, you write than and then you write the second part. Then I found my dog standing outside. This one is clear. So we use the helping verb did over here in case of the past forms. In case of the past form, you can also use had over here. Okay, you also can use had. No sooner had I opened. Now you will have to remember that when you use the word did as the helping verb, you use the first form of the verb, open. Okay, but when you use had as the helping verb, you use the third form of the verb, which is opened. Both the sentences are correct. If the sentence, as soon as the sentence is in past form, you can either use the helping verb did or you can use the helping verb had after no sooner. But you have to remember that if you use did, then the verb form needs to be the first form. And in case you use the word had as the helping verb, you need to use the third form of the verb, which is open. Do you remember the present form, the past form and the participle form? The participle form is the third form. So in this case, over here, you need to use the third form, which is opened. Let's move to the formula. Now, this one, you can write it down in your copy so that you remember. I think from the examples only, it is clear to you. But if you want to write the formula about how to frame the sentence, then you can also write these down. See, in the present form, what is the form in which way we are going to write? First, you will use the no sooner. Then you will either use do or does. So just to recapitulate, when do we use do? When the noun beside this is plural. Okay, if there were dogs, for example, if there is dogs, that is plural, then no sooner do the dogs. Okay, but if there was a single dog, then no sooner does the dog. Okay, so do is for the plural one and does is for the singular. Okay, then you finish this part of the sentence, you come to than. This one has to be written. If you have not written then you get a zero. Okay, then after you have written than, you use the first form of the verb. So let us take another example. No sooner does the dog start screaming than my father comes outside. You have to remember that this also needs to be in the present form, because the whole sentence that is given as a question is in the present form. So starting the sentence with no sooner needs to be in the present form. Next, we are coming to the past form. Now, past, in the case of past form, you have two types. Both are correct. First, you use no sooner. Then either you use the helping verb did or the helping verb can be changed to had also. You can write the helping verb as had also. Okay. So no sooner did, then you write maybe no sooner did I get up. Then, obviously, you must use this word than. Then, I saw the cow. Okay, I saw. Why in the past tense? Because the sentence is in the past form. Okay, you can also write no sooner had I opened the door. Opened, remember, this is the third form of the verb. So, no sooner had I opened the door than I saw a cow. Okay, next, this is the formula. Now we will move to type 2. What is type 2? Type 2 is the sentences that start with hardly. See the first example. No sooner did I lift the load. So one part of the sentence is what? That I am lifting the load. And the second part is that pain in my back. These are the two parts. Okay. Now I have written the sentence with no sooner and you are told to begin the sentence with hardly. How will you frame this sentence? Hardly had I lifted the load. This is similar to the no sooner sentence only. Either you add had or you add did. Both the sentences are correct. If you use the word had as the helping verb, then you write the third form of the verb. That is the participle form. Hardly had I lifted the load when I felt a pain in my back. So here you also have to remember that you use when, not than. In case of no sooner, you use the word than, but in case of hardly, you use the word when. Now, in case you use the helping verb did, then what will change? You will use the first form of the verb here, not the third form, but the first form. First form means the present form. Hardly did I lift the load when I felt a pain in my back. Okay, this thing will also be in the past tense. Why? Because the sentence is in the past form. Okay, I think this part is clear. Now we will move to the formulas. Again, if you want to copy it down, you can copy down the formulas. So how do you do the sentences which start with hardly? You can use hardly had, or you can also write hardly did. Okay, if you use the helping verb had, then you use the third form of the verb. That means hardly had I foamed my or hardly had I ironed my dress when my mother called me. So you use the word when. This is important. Okay, so hardly had I ironed my dress when my mother called me. If you use the word did, then how will you write it? You will use the first form of the verb. Hardly did I iron, not ed, iron my dress when my mother called me. Okay, in both the cases you write when. With the, just recapitulate, in no sooner you use the word than, with hardly you use the word when. We do not use any comma between the sentence, okay, or you do not use comma in any place of the sentence. In both the cases, no comma is to be used. If you put a comma in between, before when or before then you get a zero, remember. So now I think mostly it is clear to you how you frame the sentences, what are the various kinds. So we will move on to the practice sentences. Let us practice. First one, try on your own and then you check whether it is correct or not. Just as he started, first we will check what is the tense. Just as he started shaving, the lights went out. So he was shaving, okay, and then the lights went out. So this is obviously a past sentence, because you have started, went, these are words used in the past form. So what are the two helping verbs that we can use here? We can either use had, or we can also use did. So let us use had over here. Hardly had. Hardly had I started shaving. So this is the word had. So the third form of the verb needs to be used. Hardly had I started shaving when, we have to remember, with hardly we use when the lights went out. Now, if there is a child who wants to write did over here, instead of had, you want to write did. So you write it hardly did. So let's just erase this and let's think that you want to write over here did. So hardly did I start shaving. You have to remember that with did, we use the first form of the verb, which means hardly did I start shaving when the lights went out. These are the only two answers that you can write. Nothing else will be accepted over here. Let's move to question number two. Just as my mother starts cooking. First hint, see what tense it is. Starts cooking, my father goes to help her. Now this is a habitual truth. Normally whenever my mother goes to cook, my father tries to help her out. Okay, this is a habitual sentence which is always in the present form. So now, no sooner. What is the helping verb that you are going to use? You must use the helping verb over here. Okay, if you just write directly no sooner my mother starts cooking, wrong. You have to use a helping verb first. So no sooner, what are the two forms you can use here? You can use only does over here. Why not do? Because it is my mother, singular. So with singular we use does. No sooner does my mother start cooking. No sooner is given, so than. No sooner does my mother start cooking than my father goes to help her. This is the only single kind. No other kinds are possible here. Let's move to the third sentence. As soon as the children reach school, they phone their parents. What tense? First check the tense. So first the tense is in the present form. So what are the two kinds you can use over here as a helping verb? Do or does. But you have to use do over here, because see the noun, it is plural. So with plural, we can use in the present form only do. So as soon as the children reach school, they phone their parents. What will be the answer? No sooner do the children reach school. With no sooner, what do we use? Than. So no sooner do the children reach school than they phone their parents. Clear? This is the only single kind that can be used over here. Now we come to sentence number 4. As soon as the train arrived, the waiting passengers crowded. What is the tense? See, arrived, crowded. So this is the past tense. So we are talking about the past form. See, over here we are given a hint already. So if there was no hint given over here, then we could have used the word had also. But as it is already written that you have to start the sentence with no sooner did. So you cannot use had over here. So the helping verb must be did. No sooner did the train arrive. First form of the verb, did the train arrive, than the waiting passengers crowded. Clear? Now number 5. As soon as the boy came home, what is the tense? Past tense. His pet dog started screaming. So it is in the past form. So as soon as the boy came home, his pet dog started screaming. You are given to start the sentence with hardly. So you can use either had or did. So if you use the word had over here, then how will you write? Hardly had the boy come home, because come is the third form of the verb. Okay. So hardly had the boy come home when his pet dog started screaming. In case you use did over here, first I gave you the example of had. If you write did over here as the helping verb, then how will you write it? Hardly did the boy come home, his pet dog, hardly did the boy come home when his pet dog started screaming. Okay, next come to the last sentence. As soon as the boy came home, his pet dog started screaming. Now, see, in the first sentence, I discussed both. In the second, in the sixth sentence, that is in the fifth sentence, I discussed both. The same question is given over here, but you are told to start with had. Okay. You are already given here that you need to start the sentence with had. So you cannot use did. So no sooner had, you have to use the third form of the verb. No sooner had the boy come home than his pet dog started screaming. Okay. That's all. So I think this part is clear and you will not make any errors. Do slowly whenever you're giving one sentence, think how will you change it, what are the forms of the verb, what form of the verb you have to use, what word you need to use, whether you need to use when or whether you need to use than, and then first check the tense and then begin your sentence. It will never be wrong, and I hope you will get at least, if 2 marks come from these no sooner and than and hardly sentences, you will score well. And if you like my video, please subscribe and comment in the comment section. And goodbye. Thank you so much, children.